Sairam students, welcome to the second session of chapter 10, that is disaster management. So children, before starting today's session, let's revise what we had learnt in the first session. So children, in the first session we saw what is disaster, what do you mean by disaster management. Then we saw about the two types of disasters, that is natural and man-made. And then we saw about the three disasters, that is famine, flood and cloudburst. So in these disasters we saw how we can take preventive measures against these disasters, right? So today we'll start with lightning, right? So lightning is our next disaster. So this is what is lightning is, right? So in chapter 8 of static electricity, we have already learned, children, how the lightning occurs, right? Electricity is attracted towards this lightning, right? So we'll see what happens. We are going to see today what preventive measures we can take during lightning. So precautions to be taken during thunderstorms. So what is the first one? Do not stand on open ground or below a tree. Do not go to a high location or climb a tree. So whenever there is a thunderstorm, we are not supposed to stand on an open ground or below a tree. So also you are not supposed to climb on a top of a hill or climb a tree, right? Because thunderstorm, you know how it is, right? So because of the thunderstorm, the tree can fall on us, right? So we have to be very alert on it, right? So second one is, do not stand near an electric pole, a telephone pole, a tower, etc. So you are not supposed to stand near this electric pole, telephone pole and tower, because as I had told you that electricity gets attracted towards this thunderstorm and lightning. So we should not stand near these things, right? Do not lean on wired fences around a farm, a compound, a garden or a house. So you are not going to stand near the wired fences also, which is this fences which is wired around the farm, then compound, garden or a house. Next is, if you are on a two-wheeler, a bicycle, a tractor or a boat, get off immediately and go to a safe place. So if you are using any of these items, you are supposed to get from it immediately and go to a safer place. Do not gather all together in one place, right? So all will not gather in one place only, because what will happen, then everybody will be facing this thunderstorm. So take care to keep a distance of 15 feet away between any two persons. So there should be a distance of 15 feet between two persons. Next is, do not use plugged in electrical appliances. Do not use a mobile or a telephone. So as I had told you, electricity, it gets attracted, right? So towards these lightning or thunderstorm. So you should not when there is a lightning or thunderstorm, you should not use any electrical appliances, right? Also, you should not use a mobile or a telephone also. Then stand on dry wood, a plastic sheet, sack or jute cloth or dry leaves. So if you stand on these things, the lightning may not strike you, right? Because have you ever seen, children, that whenever any electricity work is done, that time they take a wooden stool, you stand on the wooden stool, right? So that that electricity, if any shock is there, you will not get it, right? So keeping your feet together, support yourself on the soles of your feet, placing your hands on your knees and crouch low. So this means that you are going to bend on your knees and you are going to lower yourself, right? Next is, swimmers or fishermen should immediately come out of the water. So this is very well understood, that they should come out of the water. A pakka house is the safest place. Find out if there is a lightning conductor on any tall building near your house. If necessary, get a lightning conductor fitted on your house. So the house, pakka house means the house which is built with cement, stones and bricks. That is called as a pakka house, right? So you should this type of house is the safest one. And as I had, we had discussed lightning conductor, right? It protects us from the, it's a device which is used to protect us from the lightning, right? So this should be installed on the tall building. So you have to find out whether your house is located near where this lightning conductor is fitted on in your, as I had told you, if it, the lightning conductor, it is fitted on a building, then the surrounding area also can be prevented from this lightning, right? So if you are not having, or in your area you don't have a lightning conductor, then you can get it fitted on your house, right? So these were the precautions which you have to take during the thunderstorms. Next is volcano. Now you can see in the volcano what happens. Now this, these are, this watch, whatever comes out, these are the different types of chemical substances which comes out from the volcano. So what is this volcano? It is a natural phenomena, it is not a man-made. So what happens in this volcano? Now you all know, children, in the earth which is there, right, in the interior of the earth, that is below the, down the earth, it is very hot, and there is a, always there is a movement of hot substances inside this earth's crust. So what happens, sometimes the liquid, the solid and the gaseous substance, the which is there below the earth's crust, they are pushed towards the crust. So when these substances, they come out of the earth's crust in an eruption and start flowing, then that is called as a volcano, right? Now this volcano, we'll see in detail. The, as I had told you, volcano, it's a natural event. Man cannot make this type of disaster. So the interior of the earth, it is very hot. As I told you, inside the earth, below the earth, it is very hot. So always there is movement of hot substances continuously occur from the interior of the earth towards the surface of the earth. So as a result, sometimes the solid, liquid and gaseous substances below the earth's crust, they are pushed towards the crust, right? So these substances, they are being pushed towards the earth's crust, and when these substances, they come out of the earth's crust in an eruption and start flowing, it is called as a volcano. So these substances, solid, liquid and gaseous substances which are there below the earth's crust, when they come out, they come out as an eruption, right? They come out as an eruption and then they start flowing, and that is called as a volcano. Now what are the effects of the volcano? The chemical substances such as lava, lava means it's a semi-fluid rock, right? Vapor, hot mud, sulfur, etc., they get collected on the surface of the earth, and thereby mountains and hills are created. Now whenever these substances, released, right, they get collected on the surface of the earth, and because of this mountains and hills are created. Then the atmosphere gets polluted due to the ash and the gases ejected by the volcano. So the atmosphere which is there, that also gets disturbed, it gets polluted because of these gases, right? Often it rains as a result of volcanic eruption, right? And temperature rises due to the hot gases. Because hot gases come out from this volcano, the temperature also increases. Forests and settlements get buried under the hot mud. So what happens? Sometimes the whole forest and gets buried under this hot mud, right? So these are the effects of the volcano. Now this volcano, it doesn't occur in land only, it occurs in sea also. And whenever it occurs in sea also, the same type of chemical substances, they come out, the, as I told you, lava, sulfur, hot mud, vapor. So these chemical substances, they get collected on the surface of the earth, right? So and sometimes what happens, when these volcanoes, they erupt in the sea, islands are also created because of this eruption of volcanoes. Now this volcano, we cannot prevent it, right? It's not possible to prevent the eruption of a volcano. So it is not in our hand to stop the volcano after it erupts, or to control it, right? So but we can predict this volcano, right? Because of the science and technology, it is possible for us to predict the eruption, and then we can take immediate steps for disaster management, right, children? So volcano, we cannot stop it or we cannot control it, right? But we can predict that a volcano can erupt, and accordingly we can take steps for disaster management. Next is tsunami. Now tsunami means this, as I had told you, volcano, it occurs in the sea. In the same way, the earthquake also, it occurs in land as well as on sea, right? So let's see. Like land, earthquakes and volcanic eruptions occur at the bottom of the sea too. So these earthquake and volcanic eruptions, they occur at the bottom of the sea. And if an earthquake occurs at the bottom of the ocean, the energy released pushes the water upwards. So if by chance this earthquake occurs at the bottom of the ocean, what happens? The energy which is released from this earthquake, it pushes the water upwards. Because of this, peculiar types of waves are formed. Now this energy which is released, it pushes the water upwards and waves are formed, right? So these waves, they are not very high near the source, but they start spreading very fast to long distances. So these waves which are generated, they are not high in near the source, right, where it is taking place, but then they spread so fast to long distances, and so much fast they spread that the velocity of these waves is around 800 to 900 kilometer per hour. When they reach the coastal area, their velocity is reduced, but their height is found to have increased tremendously, even to about 30 meters. So as these waves, they reach the coastal area, the velocity gets reduced. The velocity which is at 800 to 900 kilometer per hour, it gets reduced, but their height, it goes on increasing tremendously. Its height can be around 30 meters, right? So what is this tsunami? Definition of tsunami is a wave generated by an earthquake or volcano occurring on the ocean floor is called as a tsunami, right? So this wave which is generated by the earthquake or volcano which occurs on the ocean floor is called as the tsunami. Now tsunami, this is a Japanese word, and what it means? It means harbor wave. Tsunami means harbor wave, right? So it is a Japanese word. Now what are the destructive effects of tsunami? Building and constructions are destroyed. Large scale loss of life and financial loss. So whichever disaster it takes place, there is always a loss of life and property. Also because of that, financially also there is a loss. Boats and ships near the coast get damaged because the waves are so high, right? So trees get uprooted, landslide takes place on a large scale, right? Changes take place in the original land near the coast, giving rise to swamps. Now swamps means nothing but, children, it is an uncultivated land where the water gets collected. It is a low-lying area, like, right? So traffic obstructions arise. Definitely when the water comes on the road and all, the traffic will also get obstructed. Business, industry related to sea are adversely affected, and normal day-to-day life is disrupted. So everything gets disrupted because of this tsunami. Large scale damage is caused to harbors. Harbors, because the ships and boats, they cannot go in the sea. So there is a damage to the harbor line, right? So all the business, industry, all this gets adversely affected. Now next, the last one we are going to see is about the storm, right? So what precautions we should take during storms? So regularly cut down trees or branches that are likely to fall and cause damage. So what you are supposed to do, the trees which are there near your society or near your house, that you have to regularly cut it down, because when there is a storm, what will happen? It will fall and then it may cause damage. If you are outside, take shelter in a safe place, right? If you are not in the house and you are outside the house, then you have to take shelter in a safer place, not near any tree, right? If you are away from home, inform your close relatives and friends about your exact location so that they don't get worried where you are, right? So you have to inform them. At home, shut the walls or the gas regulators and turn off the electric supply. So when, if you are at home, then you have to, is supposed to turn off the electric supply and the gas regulator also, you have to shut it down, right? Make telephone calls to warn your relatives and friends about the probable danger. Tell them to go to a safer place. Once you hear about this storm, you can inform your relatives and friends also. And then you can tell them also to go to a safer place. Give temporary shelter to people who are far away from their homes. Right? So many people, if they are outside and the storm has come, so you can give them temporary shelter. Right? You can give, you can tell them to stay in your place for a while, and once it is the storm stops, then they can go away back to their house. Right, children? So this was what in disaster management chapter, children. So before so let's recap what we have learned today. So first we saw, children, about the lightning, what precautions we are supposed to take during lightning. Then we saw about volcano, how the volcano erupts, what are the chemical substances which are present in the volcano, and what steps we can take whenever there is a volcano, right? We can predict the eruption of volcano, but we cannot stop or control it. Then we saw what is a tsunami, how the tsunami waves are generated, and how the name tsunami has been given, right? It's a Japanese word. It has been derived from the Japanese word, and the meaning of tsunami is harbor wave. And lastly, we saw about the storms, what precautions we are supposed to take during storms. So with this, children, we finish this disaster management chapter. So in the next session, we'll start with the revision for the first semester. Till then, goodbye.